Most repairs to audio cables require the use of a soldering iron. In this video, I'll show you a variety of soldering irons to help you decide which one's best for your audio repairs. Manufacturers make it a little easier to help us work out how much heat capacity a soldering iron has by using the electrical measurement of wattage. To give you an example, one manufacturer gave these suggestions. They said a 15 watt iron will suit circuit board, micro components and thin wires. A 25 watt iron is good for general purpose parts and cables, and a 40 watt iron is suited to more automotive size cables and parts. So for our purpose, to keep it simple, a 25 to 40 watt soldering iron is more than adequate for most basic audio lead repairs. You can use higher wattage irons like the 60 watt iron, but you've got to be careful that the tip doesn't get too large for your application. And these large irons have no place in an audio technician's toolbox. They're just far too large and the tips are way too big for what we need. Now this general purpose soldering iron that you're most likely having lying in your own backyard garage is by far the most popular, and it ranges in price from $15 through to about $50 depending on the brand. And then we can move through to a temperature controlled version of the general purpose iron. It has the added benefit of a thermostat built in to help maintain a steady tip temperature of around 185 degrees Celsius or 370 degrees Fahrenheit. Now you've got to buy a good one, but these are about twice the price of a general purpose iron. But I say buy a good one because they can easily burn out because there's a lot of heat generated by these irons. And then we move to a soldering station. Typically they have a handpiece stand and an adjustable thermostat with a temperature control. These stations are designed with far better components and can heat the tip extremely quickly to keep the tip at a much more regulated temperature. These soldering stations, they range in price from around $100 right through to $250 for the better quality ones. Now moving to cordless soldering irons, they're powered by either a battery or butane gas. And they don't have the limitation of having to be connected to a household power supply. But the battery powered irons have too many limitations to be considered for audio repairs, with low wattage heating elements and short charge life that can cause more frustration than anything else. And on the other hand, gas powered irons come in a variety of styles, are very portable and easy to refill ready for use. Even so, they do have the limitation of not being thermostatically controlled and can be just a little bit tricky to maintain a steady tip temperature. Gas-powered irons range in price from really cheap ones, around $25, through to $150, depending on the brand. Now, with all this variety, how do you decide what type of iron to purchase for your basic audio repairs? Well, if you're near household power and money is limited, then a good quality, general purpose soldering iron is your first choice. And if you can afford to spend a little more money and you're near household power, then a good quality soldering station. And look, they are a far better tool. They do a far better job over a longer period of time. If total portability is your concern, then a gas powered iron would be your choice. But make sure they have replaceable tips. Now remember, you get what you pay for. Buy quality tools because they're easier to use and do a far better job over a longer period of time. Well, if you've decided to spend a little bit more money, maybe over $100, how do you know if you're looking at a good quality product? Well, is the iron that you're looking at a known brand? And does the manufacturer show a selection of different soldering irons? And two, do they display a variety of replacement tips? And three, can you get spare parts, especially for a soldering station? And four, does it have a good warranty? These are all indicators of whether it's a good quality product or not. Well, I hope that's been of some help. If you want to look up some more information about this gear, I'll leave some links in the description below. And if you'd like to learn how to use the soldering iron and do your own audio lead repairs, then in my next video, I'll show you how to do this by using only basic tools that you most likely have lying around the house. If you want a reminder when we upload our next video, make sure you subscribe. And if you've got some great ideas or tips of your own, even some questions, type them in the comments section or even connect with us with your favourite social media platform. We'd love to hear from you. Well, until our next audio tip, work safe, don't burn your fingers. Trust me, I know from experience, it's not a good feeling.